Tasks represent activities performed during a business process, such as the close cycle. Tasks have start dates and end dates. Each task has an assignee responsible for completing the task. Tasks can also be assigned approvers. You can add tasks to a template or add them directly to a schedule. When you add tasks to a template, you specify the start and end days as the number of days before day zero. When you add tasks to a schedule, you select calendar dates for the start and end days. In this tutorial, we'll add a task to a template. To add tasks, open Task Manager from the application card. Select the Task tab, and then use the Templates list to select the template to which to add tasks. I'll add a task for loading administration data to the corporate month close template. Task IDs must be unique. Organizational units are used for scheduling holidays and also for filtering and reporting. Use the source field to specify the template to which to add the task. You use this option only if you have other templates embedded in the current template. You can create parent tasks, integration tasks, and basic tasks. Parent tasks are useful for grouping tasks in schedules. Parent tasks have child tasks. The start date of the parent task is the start date of the first child task, and the end date is the end date of its last child task. Integration tasks include the application component you need to perform the task, for example, a data form embedded in the task dialog box. Basic tasks are tasks that do not have children and do not have an integration. I want this task to include a form for entering currency rate overrides for the financial consolidation and close business process. So I'll select the Enter Form Data Integration Task Type for financial consolidation and close. I'll set the priority for the task. The task owner is the manager of the task, but not necessarily the assignee. The owner can edit the task properties, such as start and end date, reassign the task assignee and approver, and force the task to close. Tasks default to active. Only active tasks are included when you create a schedule from the template. Use the Parameters tab to provide information needed by integrations. I'll select the Override Rates form. You can enter instructions for the task. In the References section, you can attach documents and add links. On the Workflow tab, you assign a user or group as the task assignee. If you select the group, any member of the group can claim the task to start working on it. You can optionally assign a backup user. The backup user automatically becomes the assignee if the assignee's status changes to unavailable. For example, if the assignee is out of the office. Next, assign a start day and end day. You can also specify a minimum duration expected for the task. Select Allow Early Start to allow the assignee to start the task before the specified start day and time have been reached. You can optionally assign an approver and a backup approver for the task. You can have up to 10 levels of approval. You can use questions to verify that proper procedures were followed in performing the task. You can select from different formats, such as yes/no and multiple choice. You can have separate questions for assignees and approvers. If you make a question required, users cannot submit or approve the task until they answer the question. You can add viewers to the task. Viewers have view-only access to the task information. You can specify a predecessor for the task. I'll select the Review New Accounts task as predecessor. the current task will not change its status from pending to open until the predecessor task is in the specified condition. If you select Finish to start as the condition, the current task cannot start until the predecessor task status is closed. If you select Finish to finish, the current task cannot close until the predecessor task status is closed. I'll select Finish to start. You can add custom attributes to the task for filtering and reporting or to collect data. I want to be able to report on all data load related tasks, so I'll add the data load attribute to flag this task as data load related. You can assign which user types can modify the attribute value. Since this attribute is used for filtering and reporting and not for data entry, I'll accept the default of view only access for all user types. You can assign rules to tasks. Rules inherited from the template display here as well. I've finished setting up this task, so I'll click Save and Close. You can add the task to a parent task. You can create tasks in a spreadsheet and then import them. You must save the spreadsheet as a comma-separated file before you can import it. You import tasks using the Actions menu. I'll select the file to import. You can choose to replace all the task information or to update only fields with changes. When the import is complete, a summary of the number of tasks created and the number updated is displayed. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.